Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad. Your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such—
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. but the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do. Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole. Here they are. Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year. Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case. Family Pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back? Hard to believe I was an eighth grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school? It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault, really, from when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me. Or it's because we can't afford nice things. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and... What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? 50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Fine, whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there are some things I want to be real clear about.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language?
Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot. Uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your... I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Oh, that's what I smell. A giant load of crap.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
At least she has a heart. All you have is... What's it called when you've got one porn stash and zero game?
I was in the army. You will respect me.
You're not my father. You're not even on the same planet as my father.
My job is to make sure you and your mother have a safe and peaceful home.
Do I come to your place of employment and... Oh, that's right. You don't have one.
If you were a man,
I... It's cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you either.
Don't know why I bother trying.
Mission accomplished. Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. Burning the midnight again. What a beautiful day.
Dad, turn it up.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. I guess Mom left her purse back here.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Hello, Black Hell.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you wanna go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now.
Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know, I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernon.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes...
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out with it.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
Ugh! Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use-
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
I wiggle my hand. Hey, dragonkin guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass, into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
You're short, I say. But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear it as a top hat. Then you'd be way taller.
The dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave!
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game!
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
Don't worry, Alamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon nods. Calamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
What's next?
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
Holy shit! Annihilation Strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
One?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
I jump in front of Elmon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant!
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Oh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon.
Durgaron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class.
Joy.
What have you got here, Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours! Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone!
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you!
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Idiot. You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
You have no idea how crazy I am. Keep pushing and find out.
You want a piece of this?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair already.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat!
You shut the fuck up!
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Oh, good. You're here.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time, the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Miranda's an idiot, because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
Actually, she's about 15, so your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive, is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so Why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah. Sure. Okay. Get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit, and don't, like, fall down. Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt.